Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you my stupidly simple styling secrets that I think everyone needs to know. These are styling secrets that everyone can incorporate into their fashion game. So I've got a ton of tips and tricks in this video that are super easy to implement and they're stupidly simple, if you will. Before I hop into the video, I quickly wanted to thank my sponsor for this video, The Real Real. I have actually been purchasing from The Real Real and consigning with The Real Real for 4 years now, and I love their service, which is why I'm so excited to be partnering with them. So if you've never heard of The Real Real before, it's basically a luxury consignment website and app that you can use to consign and also buy pre-loved designer items. You can literally get anything from Chanel, Louis Vuitton, Celine, Balenciaga, Versace, Dolce & Gabbana. And the best part is you can get all of these designer luxury brands at up to 90% off. The reason why I love shopping and selling things on The Real Real is because they have a team of experts that authenticate every single item, so you never have to worry about an item not being authentic. If you guys are interested in consigning with The Real Real, there are a couple ways that you can do that. The first way is that you can just reach out to The Real Real. They'll send you a shipping label and you can just send over any items you want to consign directly to them. The second way you can consign with The Real Real is using their white glove service, which means that a luxury consignment expert will come to your home and inspect all of the items that you want to consign right in the comfort of your own home, which is awesome. So if you guys are interested in consigning any of your luxury items with The Real Real, I'm gonna have a link in my description box down below, so feel free to check it out if you're interested. I'm also gonna include a link in my description box that will give you $25 off of your first order on The Real Real. So if you want to check that out, check my description box down below. All right, so now that you guys are familiar with how The Real Real works, let's hop into the video, because I have a few items that I picked up myself from The Real Real recently that I want to share with you guys. So my first stupidly simple styling secret is to add a backpack to any look. I don't know what it is about a backpack, but it instantly makes anything look so much cooler. If you guys follow me over on Instagram, you know that I'm obsessed with my backpacks. I have a few in my collection, and the most recent addition to that collection is this gorgeous Urban Spirit backpack from Chanel. This is red calfskin leather with gold hardware. I cannot tell you how obsessed I am with it. If you follow me over on Instagram, you can probably tell how obsessed I was with it when I was in Miami, because I pretty much wore it with everything and anything. Because first of all, it just gives any outfit this beautiful pop of color. Even if you're wearing all neutrals, it just lends a special something to that look. Secondly, the style of this bag is just so laid back, so cool, and it just instantly elevates any look. And I love the size of this one. I do have a smaller Urban Spirit backpack in the nude color with the chevron quilting that's a little bit smaller than this. So when I got this backpack in the mail, it was literally in perfect condition. There's a tiny little mark on the inside of the bag, nothing on the outside. The outside looks virtually brand spanking new. So I was so impressed with this. It came with its original dust bag with all the certifications, and I just love this bag. Obviously, I'm not saying go out there and find yourself a Chanel backpack. There are a ton of dupes on the high street that you can check out with the quilting detail. I just personally am a Chanel backpack fanatic. I'm a Chanel bag fanatic in general. So this was a lovely addition to my collection. I'd rather have less pieces in my collection that are more higher quality and that I wear and reach for all the time than a ton of less expensive handbags that I reach for maybe once or twice. If you guys are in the market for a designer backpack, not necessarily Chanel, you can go on The Real Real and just type in backpack in the search bar, and you're going to find a ton of amazing luxury designer backpacks that are on steep discount. A styling secret that I personally use probably on a daily basis is to save fashion inspiration photos. Now, there's several different ways you can do this. You can save them on your phone, you can save them on your computer, you can make a Pinterest board. My personal favorite way is to save all of these photos in my saved folder on Instagram, because that's where I tend to look to for different fashion inspiration posts. So I have a whole folder on my Instagram page that is of saved photos, and I save these photos based on a few things. They're not always fashion inspiration photos. I mean, I have like a few food photos thrown in there of restaurants that I want to check out, but most of the fashion photos are photos that I use as inspiration when I'm putting together my own outfits, or maybe if I'm looking to recreate a similar pose or a similar background. Anytime I want to put an outfit together and I'm lacking some inspiration, that's the folder I always go to. Ending off on there and segueing into my next point, in order for me to be able to create these beautiful saved images on my Instagram account, I like to follow Instagram influencers or bloggers or whatever you want to call them that kind of have like a similar style or a style that I get really inspired by and kind of want to incorporate pieces of into my own style. That way I don't have to go out and actually search for them. They're just going to automatically pop up on my feed and I can just save them as I scroll through the never-ending Instagram feed. So once you have your folder of saved photos, wherever it may be, go into your closet and see what items you already have that are similar to those outfits that you liked or you saved, and try styling them yourself with pieces that you already own. A lot of the time, we already own a lot of these pieces that we see on Instagram or Pinterest or wherever it may be, and it's just a matter of putting two and two together and seeing how certain pieces fit together when you see it on somebody else. Another really important styling secret is to really, really understand your body type and know what you feel most comfortable in. There is nothing more cool than a girl with confidence. I mean, you could be wearing a white t-shirt and jeans and sneakers, but if you have an attitude and you have a confident aura about it, anything that you put on will instantly look super cool. Another thing I like to do once in a while whenever I have time is to put a few outfits together and take photos of any of the outfits that I think look really, really good together. That way I have them documented somewhere, either on my phone or my computer. That way if I'm going out somewhere and I need to put an outfit together really fast but I'm stumped for ideas, I can just use those photos as a reference. And you don't even have to try them on if you don't want to. You can kind of just lay them out on your floor or on your bed. I do that a lot as well, but that way you can kind of see if like the color tones go together, if the textures go together. You get the point. Another one of my favorite things to do is to kind of batch outfits together and put them in a section of my closet where they're just like ready to go and I can just pull them out and throw them on. So for this, you probably have to pre-plan a little bit. You probably would have to try these garments on together first to see how they all look together and how you feel in them. And then I would just take all of the hangers for these garments, kind of sandwich them together, tie them with an elastic at the top, and I would have like 3 or 5 of these outfits just ready to go. That way I have an outfit for any kind of occasion. A styling secret of mine that I have shared on this channel a couple of times is to invest in high quality basics. I cannot emphasize this enough. Having good fitting and good high quality basics in your wardrobe can make all the difference in the world, not only in how you look and how these certain pieces can be styled, but also how you feel. There's nothing worse than throwing on a shirt or a sweater that has pilling on it, that has threads coming out of it, that doesn't keep its shape when you first bought it. And basics are something that you're gonna have in your wardrobe for years and years and years because they transcend the trends. That's why I highly recommend spending a little bit more money on things that you know you're gonna keep for a long time. So just as important as investing into high quality basics, I think it's likely as important to invest in high quality transitional pieces because these are pieces that are also going to transcend the trends, get you through season, through season, through season, especially if you are a Canuck like me and you have 4 very different seasons, winter, fall, spring, and summer. You know, sometimes I think to myself, if I lived in a warmer climate, I would spend probably half the amount I do on clothing. So that's why when I'm buying items, I think to myself, okay, can I wear this right now? Can I wear this in the spring? Can I wear it when it's gonna be super scorching hot in the summertime? And if the answer is yes, then normally that's a piece that I will invest my money in because I know that I can style it in different ways and layer certain pieces underneath depending on what the climate is. One of my favorite transitional pieces to invest in is a good blazer because blazers are something that I wear all year round as well as trousers and turtlenecks. Okay, I wouldn't wear a turtleneck in the summertime, but in the springtime or in the fall time, I think a thinner turtleneck like this is perfect to pair with so many different looks. And in the wintertime, I would just layer it underneath a chunky knit sweater and just throw on an oversized coat and I'm good to go. Another one of my styling secrets is to stick with a very similar color palette in your wardrobe. This is going to ensure that you can mix and match a ton of different pieces together. A lot of your pieces will be transitional. You're gonna need a lot less clothing in your closet to put together an outfit. Now, I'm not saying you shouldn't throw color in there at all. I personally have a mainly neutral wardrobe. Majority of my wardrobe is white, gray, black, camel. I've got a lot of camel. But my favorite way of adding a pop of color is with a bold statement coat or a bold bag or a bold pair of shoes. There are so many different ways that you can kind of add a pop of color to your look without spending a lot of money on unnecessary clothing. So leading into my next styling secret is to make a statement with accessories. I cannot even begin to tell you how important it is to accessorize if you want to appear more fashion forward, if you will. My personal favorite ways of accessorizing is with sunglasses, with belts, with handbags, with shoes. Those are my weaknesses. So I wanted to show you a few of my favorites. I have one very, very special favorite, and the other two are actually recent purchases of mine, but they are all from The RealReal. So I wanted to start off by showing you these Dolce & Gabbana sunglasses that I got from The RealReal 4 years ago, and I kid you not when I tell you that I wear these every single day. I call these my incognito sunglasses because they are freaking huge. They literally cover half of my face, and if I'm not feeling that great or if I don't have a slick of makeup that day and I just want to go out into the world and not be bothered and not be recognized, this is what I wear, which is every day. So I'm obsessed with these. These originally were like $500 or $600 retail, and I got them on The RealReal for $100. These are like indestructible. I throw these in my bag without their case all the time. Don't do that. You should definitely not do that because I've damaged quite a few pairs of sunglasses doing that. But these ones, for some reason, are so resilient. And I feel like I've already gotten my wear out of them because I've literally worn them every single day for the last 4 years. I don't know what I would do if I lost these or if something happened to these, because to me, they're irreplaceable. Not only do they have so much character, and I have had these for so, so long, these are just like my security blanket. And I feel like it's so hard to find a good quality, oversized, black on black aviator sunglasses these days. So that's why I am so attached to these, and they're just amazing. My next pair of sunglasses I wanted to share with you guys is another purchase from The RealReal, but this has been the most recent, and it's a pair of Dior sunglasses. I lived in these, lived in them when I was in Miami, and they are so freaking cool. I'm just so obsessed. So these are the Dior Surreals. It's not a new style. It's been around for the last couple of years, but I love this color combination. Color. Learn to speak English, Nikki. Thank you. I love this color combination. I love the tortoise or tortoise with the chrome metal detail. I love the black lens. They're just so freaking cool. You can literally wear these with a t-shirt and jeans, and your outfit is gonna look like the coolest outfit on the block. And my last accessories purchase from The RealReal most recently is this vintage Dolce & Gabbana belt. This is like vintage. It's got watermarks. I think it originally used to be like a medium brown color, but it is so worn and so loved and discolored that it is like this deep dark chocolate brown. It has a brushed kind of gold hardware on it. And you know what? I love it. I love that it looks so vintage and so used. And as you can see, the leather is just like butter. So because this belt is massive, I'm pretty sure this is a men's belt. Just took it to like a shoe cobbler or whatever. There's this place across the street from us where we live in Miami. They fix shoes, they do dry cleaning, they do alterations, they poke holes in leather belts. So I just took it to them and it was like $5 a hole. I basically had them measure the circumference of my waist, so the smallest part of my waist, because I knew that I would want to wear this as a waist belt as well. So they punctured a hole there so that I could wear it around my waist. And then I asked them to puncture another hole where I would normally wear my high-rise jeans so that I can wear it around my hips as well. So this was such a good find. I'm actually so happy with it, obviously because it's super old. It didn't come with the original dust bag or the original box that the previous owner probably had when they purchased it. But in that case, The Real Real does supply their own dust bags, which is awesome. So if you do want to put them away and store them when you're not wearing them, you can just use the ones provided by The Real Real. Another styling tip of mine is to regularly go through my entire wardrobe and just get rid of anything that I haven't worn in over a year. That's like a very, very, very strict rule of mine, with the exception of a couple items that I love and adore and I think, okay, like I need to wear that. I'm gonna figure out how I'm going to incorporate it into an outfit. And if I don't do that within the next 6 months or whatever my time frame is, then I'll get rid of it. So I do these clear outs of my closet probably every 2 to 3 months or so. I get rid of a ton of clothes, and most of the clothes I clear out, I put it up on my Depop. If you guys are not following me over on Depop, I highly recommend you do so, because I'm constantly putting up gently worn items up on there that are pretty much in perfect condition. Sometimes I put things up that are brand new. And another thing that I do is all of the proceeds that I raise from the sale of these items, I donate to the BCRF, which is the Breast Cancer Research Foundation. My grandmother on my mom's side passed away from breast cancer, so it's a charity that is very near and dear to my heart. So that's why I try to do my best to support them in any way that I can. So that's kind of my way of recycling my clothes and also giving back to people in need. Another one of my styling secrets is to master the art of layering. Now, if I'm completely honest, this technique took me a while to master, if you will, because it's not the easiest thing to do. You really need to know sizing, textures, lengths really, really well. So for example, I would never layer two chunky knit sweaters on top of each other, because that would just be redundant and it would just make you look like the Michelin man. But what I would do is layer a kind of flowy long dress shirt underneath a chunky knit sweater. That way you can clearly see that I'm layering two pieces and it kind of creates some dimension. Speaking of the Michelin man, let's talk about proportions. So I think proportions is another styling secret of mine that has really helped me elevate my look. This was another thing that took me a while to kind of master, but to kind of narrow the scope of basics a little bit. Basically, I never wear anything too puffy or too chunky on top and too chunky on the bottom. If I'm wearing something chunky on top, I'm going to wear something more tailored and streamlined on the bottom, and vice versa. If I'm wearing something more billowy on the bottom, like a billowy, flowy, or poofy skirt, I would never wear a poofy top on top. I would wear something like this that is more fitted, and that way I'm balancing out proportions and not distorting my body in any way. Unless you want to distort your body in some way. I don't know, maybe some people like to look like a marshmallow puff. Another styling trick that I like to do all the time is to juxtapose different styles. One of my tried and true tricks is to juxtapose feminine pieces with masculine pieces. One of my favorite ways to do this is to pair like a lacy dress with a leather jacket, or maybe a leather leggings with a tweed blazer. I personally feel that anytime you kind of strictly stick with one kind of look, like an all preppy look or an all badass biker look, it kind of looks expected. So if you want to make yourself look a little bit more effortless and cool and edgy, mixing different styles together is probably one of the easiest ways to do that. Another one of my favorite ways to look effortless and cool is to juxtapose different textures. So I briefly touched on kind of juxtaposing lace and leather, but that was more like styles. If you're sticking with a similar style, juxtaposing textures is a great way to break it up. For example, one of my favorite combos is to throw on just like a shiny pair of patterned leggings with a chunky knit sweater. If you think about it, leggings and a chunky sweater are so basic, but just juxtaposing the textures in that way creates a lot of interest. And last but not least, when in doubt, go monochromatic. There's just something about going monochromatic from head to toe that just instantly makes everything look better. It elongates your look, it makes you look super chic and sophisticated, it makes you look more streamlined, and you can literally do this with virtually any color. Some of my favorites are camel, white, black, gray, the usual colors, you know. I've also seen khaki done from head to toe that looks so good. So just experiment with your style, see what you're comfortable in, and just have fun with it. A big part of finding your style and kind of feeling comfortable in your own skin is just to experiment and try all of these things that are kind of outside of your comfort zone. I did that for years. I did that probably since elementary school, and let me tell you, there have been a lot more misses than hits in my fashion history lookbook, if you will. I still feel like I'm constantly evolving my style and trying to figure out what looks best on me, what I feel the best in, and what just meshes with my personality the most. To be honest, I feel like a different person every single day, so that's kind of a tricky one. And if I'm completely honest with you guys, most of the time I live in a sweatshirt and sweatpants and sneakers. That is like my go-to uniform. And these. I can't forget about my babies. All right, you guys, so that wraps up today's video. I really hope that you enjoyed it and learned something new from my tips and tricks. Again, I want to give a huge thank you to The RealReal for partnering with me on this video. I love you guys, I love your service, and I really hope that you guys that are watching this will go check them out, because I've honestly found some of my favorite pieces from The RealReal, and these are items that are gonna stay in my wardrobe probably for a lifetime. You know, it would be really interesting. I'm curious to know if any of you have ever purchased a pre-loved luxury designer item ever and what it was. So let me know in the comments below. I want to know your story and how you found this item and how you feel about it. That'd be super cool to hear. And as always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in my next one.